fellow language. No matter you are Toastmasters or not, do you still remember your first moment you met Toastmasters? How did it look like? How do you feel? And what had happened after that in your journey? I have a very special Toastmasters journey. And actually, I met you, named in Toastmasters Club, on a halfway during my journey. I always want to take a chance to share my story from the beginning to the end to with you. And finally tonight, I finally got the chance. The story could be dated back to many years ago. At that time, I'm a girl with an extremely introvert personality and very sensitive. The only thing, the way I communicate with the world is only by body language. Agree? Disagree? To deal with the daily affair. I don't like to talk with others with my voice because I have no confidence on myself. Some people said I have social defect, and some people guess I might be a mute because I never talk to others with my voice. But the only thing I hear is that speaking to others is the best thing I would like to do in my life. 2004, in my senior high school, the things got worse in my English class. I have a very special English teacher. She sometimes asks us to prepare a speech, to stand on stage and share for 3 to 5 minutes. Sometimes she asks us to be the host of the English class to conduct a lot of activities. And sometimes she will prepare some questions to ask us and randomly pick out among our classmates to answer them. It's very terrifying for me. For me, as a girl who dare not talk to others, even in Chinese, even face to face, for one person face to face, how could I ask it by my teacher to speak English in front of a group of my classmates? As you can imagine, I had a very terrible time, a terrible life in my senior high school in English class. But thanks to my good grades of listening, reading, and writing, I still got good grades and entered my ideal university. But this terrible experience in English class is also always bear in mind, and I tell myself, speaking in front of the public, especially in English, is my actual skill, my forever weakness, and I had better avoid this part in the rest of my life. 2006, I entered university, and I joined the club exhibition in my club, in my university. Within that club exhibition, there are a lot of clubs for us to choose the best club you would like to spend your university life. I also went there and just see a lot of sports car, art club, music club, and handicrafts. Wow, that's so interesting. Which one will I choose? But suddenly, I see a yellow flag. What's that? Toast of Masters. It's the first list. I see the slogan there. A stage for you to conquer your stage fright and enjoy public speaking. Stay there and said, come on, will anyone choose this kind of club to spend their colorful young university life? Amazing. But I still take the advertisement. After I dealing with a lot of clubs, the sheets at home, choosing a club I like, I just cannot forget what I saw, the yellow flag. I'm just curious about, will anyone choose this kind of club in university life? I cannot help but to go to PPT, blog, and album to see the pictures of this club, NTU Toastmasters Club. I see the album of their regular meeting. There are a lot of pictures of their delivery when they stand on the stage. Wow, they all laughed there. They just, this, that, like this. I cannot believe what they are doing. How could they even laugh when they do public speaking? Are they aliens? I also thought they are aliens. Oh, I cannot believe they are this kind of person. But 1 week later, I still log in the PTT and to follow their next meeting. And next week, I follow their meeting. And just, I follow their meeting weekly for 1 year.
Oh,
just looking at their picture and think, what happened to them? 1 year later, I finally cannot control my curiosity. I just say, maybe I can go and take a visit to see what kind of aliens they are. So I finally enter, join their regular meeting to see who they are. I just hide in a crowded, just say no to all the introduction time, but I just observe all the people stand on stage. To my surprise, their English is not so good. However, they all laughed happily and show their confidence and show their enjoyment on the stage. I cannot believe what happened to them, but I did see that kind of pictures. Next week, I go to their meeting again. And next week, I also visit their club. When I was sometimes I'm unlucky to be picked up as a table topic speaker. I would just say, no, don't choose me. Are you an angel? No. And sometimes in the picture, the master just asked me to hear. I would just rush out of the room and hide in the toilet until the intermission. I did do that. That year, I will never be called upon on stage. That will make me die. But I don't know why. I just want to visit them. I visit them weekly because they are weekly meeting. Every meeting of them for another 1 year. I just be the guest, avoid introduction for 1 year. One day, I met a special girl. She is a very senior member and a student in my university, majoring in Japanese. She is very kind and very soft. Have a very wonderful, excellent English. He just told me, are you Angel? Well, nice to meet you. And will you join our club? And I really want to listen to your speech. Someone want to listen to my speech? Really? But she has such a good English, so I thought I'm different from her. So I said, no, I won't deliver your speech. I won't join. One day, a very senior district leader, I don't know who he is at that time, but I know this time now. He just told me, hey, what's your name? I see you so many times, but I haven't listened to your speech. What's your name? Oh, you're Angel. I saw you kept taking pictures for others. But maybe it's time to put up your camera. I can take a picture for you. I want to listen to your speech. Oh, district leader. He want to listen to my speech. But I say no. I'm sorry, I won't join. I'm just camera girl, let you know. It's a deadline of the membership payment of that club. I just also visit there. And one member asked me, the cute girl asked me, hey, I'm paying the membership. Will you pay together with me? You will pay, right? And I say yes. Okay, I will pay. I just line up and pay the membership. So many years later, 2008, I finally joined NTU Toastmasters as a member and delivered my C1 speech after that. In my C1 speech, that is my first time to speak in front of so many people with my voice. I even feel so surprised that, oh, this is my voice. And when I see the audience, they stare at me. They're so concentrated on me, listen to my speech. After that, I cannot forget that kind of feeling. I really get addicted to that kind of feeling after that. And then I deliver my C2, C3, and then the EVP assigned me to be the evaluator and session master. I know this is more challenging for me because I cannot control the chaotic response from the audience. I don't know how to give feedback as an impromptu speech. So I have a very terrible performance of the evaluator and session master. But my mentor kept told me, this is a stage, you can make mistakes, don't worry. So I believe her. I keep trying as an evaluator for C1 and C2. But gradually, I find my officer did not want to assign me as an evaluator or a session master. They just asked me to be the art counter or camera girl only. I thought, yeah, maybe I can take a chance to learn a lot from others before I take the next chance. And one day I listened to a response from my member. Hey, is she a new member? How terrible her evaluation is. And someone said, hey, is she an NTU student? How poor her English is. I feel hurt when I listen to these kind of words. But I just told myself, I'm such an introvert girl. I'm not good at this. So I need more practice to catch up with others. That's okay, this is stage for me to make mistakes. But one day, I received a feedback sheet from the audience, anonymous. It said, would you please don't ruin the quality of our meeting? Be well prepared before you stand on that wonderful stage. And that night, I did not sleep for a whole night. I never forget that feedback sheet. I always believe this is a stage the audience will allow me to make mistakes. However, I feel being cheated by them. How come? How come I have this kind of dream to conquer my Achilles heel? I will never touch this kind of part in the rest of my life. I quit NTU Toastmaster and Toastmasters after that night. I never came back to Toastmasters for 1 year. During that year at home, I cried very often and feel very, very sad. I tried to overcome my obstacle, but it turns out to be I could never make it. I feel very, very sad every day. One day, I received an email from a sister Toastmaster club. He asked me, hey, Angel, will you be the evaluator of our meeting? I just replied to her, sorry, my evaluation is very terrible. I had better not visit your meeting. But she replied me, don't worry, we really need your support. You can just come to enjoy our snacks, our environment. That's okay, just come. And then I went there. When I visit there, they treat me as a VIP guest. Ah, Angels, this is your seat. This is our agenda, and this is our officer, and so on. And after the evaluation, I still did a very terrible evaluation. As always, I say sorry to the speaker, sorry. But they just shake hands with me and give me appreciation of certificate and say, I really appreciate your help here. The time you spend with me is the best gift you give me today. Don't worry, please visit us our club next time. I feel surprised. I visit their club very often. I practiced being the individual evaluator and the session master for over 90 times in that 1 year. 90 times, every meeting I've been an evaluator. I really want to make it, although I say, I cannot. After 1 year, I received another email from NTU Toastmaster. They asked me, hey, Angel, haven't seen you for a long time. By the way, can you be an evaluator tonight? We need a firefighter. Originally, I didn't want to reply then, but I still went there. That is, when I stand on stage, my improvement surprised all the old members. I improved a lot right after that. They greet me and enjoy my evaluation. They say, come again, be our member again. Actually, I didn't feel so happy. But at that time, I see a lot of new guests there. They are so introvert, shy, sensitive, and innocent. How if I can come back and help them to get through their difficulties in their early Toastmaster life? So I come back to NTU Toastmasters and have a lot of mentees enjoy my Toastmasters life there. Since time is so limited, I would like to wrap up a little bit. After that, I joined NAEHU Toastmasters after graduation. Actually, when I met you, I had already overcome my big obstacle in Toastmasters. And then I decided to try some new things and to practice more in my next new club. Then I choose you, NAEHU Toastmasters. So I deliver most of my speeches here. I'm only CC when I join this club, but I go to ACB, ACAC, and SEG, deliver a lot of. And I also try workshop for my first time. I haven't delivered workshop before, but you always invite me to do that. So I got my CL, AC, ALB, and ALS after that. Also, because I also met a very important person in my Toastmaster life. Actually, she's here. Without her, I will never take the role as area director, area governor, governor, district director, division director, and so on. That made me learn a lot, another track of leadership track in Toastmasters. Actually, this is not the end to say all my story, because 10 minutes is too limited. But I really want to share the story of me that you had not experienced before. And then after you know the complete me, I believe we can share more, deeper, and have more things in the future. This is not the end, so I will keep continuing on my Toastmaster journey and share with you next time. And this time, this is a great time to share with you when I achieve the final target of Toastmasters. And next time, I will share more others with you. Thank you. I always thought Caroline is the guardian of my Toastmasters. So maybe I'll use another speech to introduce these stories. I invite Caroline to give herself.